Modal auxiliaries in German. What is a modal or modal auxiliary? In simplest terms in English, it's the helping verb. In English, we have a subject of a sentence and a verb of the verb of the sentence. A verb is a verb phrase if it has two or more verbs. So helping verbs are used with main verbs to complete a verb phrase. Modals, by definition, do not change the tense of the sentence. They do, however, change the meaning or set the mood. Let's take a look at a few examples here. If we have the sentence, Ms. Brown drinks the apple juice. We can translate that by saying, Frau Brown trinkt, and apple juice is der Apfelsaft, and since this is the accusative case or direct object, we would say den Apfelsaft. So notice that this sentence is fairly straightforward. Subject, Frau Brown, what is she doing? Drinking. Trinkt what? Who or what? Direct object or accusative, Apfelsaft. Now, the tense will stay the same. So if we have here the tense being present tense, here, this is just now Ms. Brown should drink the apple juice. And that's where the modal comes in. So in English, we have should drink is the verb phrase. Drink is the main verb. And should is a helping verb. It helps the main verb of the verb phrase. So this is what it would look like in German. And this is what we'll be looking at right now. Frau Brown soll den Apfelsaft trinken. This sentence in German says, Ms. Brown should drink the apple juice. Notice in direct translation, it is, Ms. Brown should the apple juice drink. So what are some of the things that you notice that occur here in this German sentence? One of the things you might notice is that the verb is split. In English, the verb is should drink. The complete verb phrase is together. In German, we have one part of the verb should here, and we have another part of the verb here at the end. Another thing you might notice is trinken is conjugated here, but when the main verb is used with a helping verb, trinkt. It's not conjugated here. It is now the full infinitive form of the verb. Let's dissect this further. So, we have a helping verb and a main verb. So, a few things to note would be that the helping verb or the modal, the helping verb or the modal is conjugated and is in the second position within the sentence. This is the position that's normally held by the verb. Then the second thing that occurs is that the infinitive of the main verb is placed at the end of the sentence. So if you look back at this example, Frau Brown soll den Apfelsaft trinken. You have these two rules come into play. The helping verb or modal is conjugated and it is in the second position of the sentence. That's the position normally held by the verb. The infinitive of the main verb is then placed at the end of the sentence. So before we dive into the modals, here are some simple examples So you can see those come into play. The modals or helping verbs will be conjugated and in the second position. And then the infinitive of the main verb, so in this case is go, is placed at the end of the sentence. So we will see these as examples. Ich will nach Hause gehen. I want to go home. Ich soll nach Hause gehen. I should go home, or I am supposed to go home. Ich muss nach Hause gehen. I have to go home, or I must go home. Ich darf. Ich darf nach Hause gehen. I may go home. Ich kann nach Hause gehen. I can go home. And this is a special modal. It's a polite request. It's a subjunctive. Ich möchte. Ich möchte nach Hause gehen. I would like to go home. So the helping verbs or modals are conjugated and put in the second position. And then the infinitives of the main verbs are then put at the end of the sentence or clause. So we'll look at seven modals or modal auxiliaries. See if you can notice the pattern in these conjugations. So first we have mögen. Mögen means to like. Ich mag, du magst, sie es mag, wir mögen, mögt, sie mögen. So notice in the singular, there's a vowel change here. Ich and sie es are the same, and wir and sie are the same. Möchten, would like to. Ich möchte, du möchtest, sie es möchte, wir möchten, möchtet, sie möchten. Müssen, must or have to. Ich muss, du musst, sie es muss, wir müssen, müsst, sie müssen. So, umlauts, no umlauts. Wollen, ich will, du willst, sie es will, wir wollen, wollt, sie wollen. So, stem vowel change here, O to I, and then here, the O's. So once again, the ich's across the board and the sie's are across the board are the same, the wir's across the board are the same, as are the z's. So here's four. Pause and make sure you have these written down. The last three, make sure you write these down and conjugate. Dürfen, may, or to be allowed to. So may and can we see used a lot. Sort of like, can I go to the bathroom? No, yes you can, but may you go. So same thing with German. Ich darf, du darfst, sie es darf, wir dürfen, dürft, sie dürfen. So the ich and the sie es, the wir and the sie are parallel. Können, can, or to be able to. Ich kann, du kannst, sie es kann, wir können, könnt, sie können. And finally, the easiest of them all, because there's not a lot of vowel change going on. Should or supposed to. Ich soll, du sollst, sie soll, wir sollen, sollt, sie sollen. So, from the singulars above to the plurals below, it's in the singulars we have to watch out for vowels. But the plurals are pretty consistent with what we've seen already in conjugation. So, zum Beispiel, try these two examples auf Deutsch. When you're ready, resume the video to check your answer. Hans and Heidi want to go home. So want is wollen. Hans und Heidi wollen nach Hause gehen. Remembering your movement in the direction towards, it's nach Hause versus zu Hause. Would you like a glass of milk? So this is a question, so we have to watch out for inverted word order. Möchtest du ein Glas Milch haben? So make any corrections as needed. And now make sure that you circle the modals in your sentences and underline the main verb infinitives. So circle the modals and underline the main verb infinitives. So try your hand at these. I really enjoy Calvin and Hobbes. So here's some Calvin and Hobbes in German. On your piece of paper, go ahead and translate each panel of this Calvin and Hobbes comic, and then a second one, and underline the modal. So once you've translated it, underline what that modal is, and hopefully you should see some. So here we go for this comic. If you don't know the words and you won't know all of them, feel free to use my favorite online dictionary, dict.leo.org, to help you. Just make sure you get the gist of the translation. Obviously, no translation for this panel, but you could explain what happens. So, du willst also Wasser haben wie? Hier habe ich eine große Kanne voll. B. Ich bestimme, ob ihr Wasser kriegt oder nicht. Ich bestimme euer Schicksal. Euer Leben selbst liegt in meiner Hand. C. Ohne mich seid ihr so gut wie tot. Ohne mich könnt ihr nicht. Und es regnet. So pause to translate those and resume for the next comic. Nummer zwei. A. Das grüne Zeug esse ich nicht. Nicht. B. Sehr schlau, Calvin. Es ist ein Teller voll Giftmüll und wenn du es isst, wirst du zum Mutanten. Ah, klatsch, schmatz. So notice some of this German noises here, like onomatopoeia. Here from Calvin, the mom. Es muss eine bessere Methode geben, ihn zum Essen zu bringen. And then Calvin says, ah, ich spüre schon, wie es wirkt. So just try your best. If you can't figure out all the words, at least write down all the modals that you see.